Hello viewers, we have already seen how the fabrics are actually selected as per our figure type, and we have to also see how the styles are going to be. And when we are looking at the garments, if you want to select the garment or you get it made by a tailor, and we need to know the workmanship of the garment that we are going to wear, because it will decide the durability of the garment later, and so we have to be careful with the workmanship of the garment. The most important item in that is that is a seam. That means a seam is a method of joining two or more pieces of materials together by a row of stitching. The purpose of most of these seams is purely functional and can be called as constructional seams. Seams should be flat as possible, unseen, except that some of those things which are used for the decorative purpose for garment design and the line. Seams can be classified into flat seams and also ridge type of seams. Plain seam and flat fell seam are examples of the flat seams. Ridge seams include the French seam and some other cord seam and other things. Seams may also be divided into conspicuous and inconspicuous seams. Inconspicuous seams, when finished, will not have stitches seen on the right side of the garment. Examples are again plain and French seams. And conspicuous seams are those that have stitches seen on the right side of the garment, like a run and fell seam, lappet seam, top stitched seam, etc. The type of seam to be used on a garment will depend upon various factors. They are the texture and durability of the fabric. That means that when working with a heavy fabric, one should avoid bulky seams like French seam. And then the design and use of the garment. When making a boyish sport shirt, a strong seam like a flat fell seam should be used. And then shape of the seam. Seams may be either straight or curved. Straight seams may be in vertical or horizontal or slanting directions of the dress. When joining curved edges, plain seam will give a better finish than the French seam. And location of the seam is also an important factor. Seams in parts of the garment which may get stretched during body movement will have to be made more durable than the others. And of course, we have the current fashion, the trend that is present at the time of the season and also making the garment has to be considered while selecting the seams. And now we'll see what are the types of seams that are present. So the popular seam, that is a plain seam, it is also referred as master seam, and it is the most widely used seam in garment making. Plain seam is the easiest way of making seams and is used on all types of fabrics except on very transparent types. It is a pliable seam and it is inconspicuous and is suitable for mostly the firm fabrics. They do not ravel and will not be subjected to hard and frequent laundering. Plain seam can also be successfully employed for stitching curved seams. This is used for side seams, underarm seams, and also armhole seams. And to make straight seams, place the two fabric pieces together with their right sides facing each other, matching the seam line and the notches they are made any. Place the pins right angles to the seam line and put a row of basting stitches along the seam line. The pins are later removed and the permanent machine stitches are made exactly on the seam line. Then to make this plain weave on the curved edges, and in order to make it very smooth and curved seam, reduce the stitch length and also stitch along the curved seam line. For inward or a concave curve, clip the seam allowances so that the seam lies flat when pressed open. For outward or convex curves, cut wedge shaped notches from the seam allowances to give a flat edge when the seam is pressed open. When a concave edge is to be stitched with a convex edge, as in princess line, stay stitch both the curves and clip the inward curves at even intervals. Pin the two sections together with the raw edges even and spread the clips so that the inward curve fits the out curve in a smooth way. Stitch the seam and press it open. Notch the seam allowances, the triples from the outward curve. Then, and make a cornered seam. Then, to strengthen the seams at corner, reduce the stitch length. Stitch to the corner, pivoting the needle point in the corners. Then, turn the fabric and continue to stitch with small stitch length. Reinforce the seam till 2.5 cm each side of the corner to prevent from fraying after it is trimmed off at the corner, and turn the right sides out. At pointed outward corners, for example, collar point, take one or two diagonal stitches across the point instead of stitching right up to the point. Trim the corner diagonally to reduce bulk before turning inside out. For inward corner, clip almost to the stitch line to ensure smooth corner when they are turned outside right. To join an inward corner to an outward corner, for example, in a yoke, first reinforce the inward corner with small stitches and clip just to the stitching line. Pin the two sections together along one edge with the clipped section on top and stitch the corner. Leave the needle in the fabric and raise the presser foot. Pivot by turning the fabric around the needle, then spread the clipped edges apart to match the next edge. Lower the presser foot and continue stitching. For lightweight fabric, stitch to the corner, pivot and take one stitch across the apex of the corner. Pivot again and stitch on. For medium weight fabrics, take two stitches across the apex of the corner. For heavy weight fabrics, take three stitches across the point. Then coming to the flat felt seam, this type of seam is mostly used on men's sports shirts, work clothes and children's clothes, pajamas and mostly jeans. The right side of the seam will show two rows of stitching and wrong side will show only one row of stitching. This is also suitable for undergarments which come in direct contact with the skin as well as in a reversible garments. While making the seam, a plain seam should be made first by leaving 1 cm allowance. After pressing the seam to one side, trim the underneath seam edge. Turn upper edge over the trimmed edge encasing it. And stitch close to the folded edge using machine or hem stitches. Precaution needs to be taken to turn the edges onto the side of relevance, such as the blouse turns over the sleeve at the armhole level, the back turns over the front at the shoulder level, and the yoke turns over the blouse at the yoke. When it is finished by hemming, it is referred as hemmed felt seam. Then coming to the most important seam that is generally used on the transparent fabrics is the French seam. This is a red seam and generally used on the transparent and lightweight fabrics, especially on baby clothes and delicate blouses. And it is a neat and durable finish as the raw edges are completely concealed. It is suitable for thin fabrics only, as this adds little bulk to the seam. Thus, it is suitable on sheer and fraying fabrics like voile, georgette, etc., as it prevents the raw edges from fraying and also presents neat enclosed edge. With the wrong sides together, stitch 0.3 cm from the cut edge. Press the turnings together to one side. Turn the fabric so that the right sides are together. And stitch on the seam line enclosing the raw edges. And then coming to the counter seam, this is also a durable flat seam used for very thick materials such as menswear and also reversible garments. This is mainly employed for reducing the thickness at the seam level. This can be made by one of the two methods that can be employed. In the first method, turn down a little on wrong side of one piece of fabric and then right side of the other piece. And then iron them firmly. Keep wrong side of the first piece of the fabric on the right side of the second piece along the edges and maintaining the seam allowances and tack it in position. Machine stitch along the folded edges. This is called three layered counter seam. And to make the other seam, turn down 0.5 cm on the wrong side of the one piece of fabric and on the right side of the other fabric and iron them firmly. Keep wrong side of the first piece on the right side of the second piece and slip the turn down edges under each other. Pin it in position, tack it and machine stitch along the folded edges from the right and wrong sides. And this is called four layered counter seam. In coming to the decorative seam, here this category includes the seams that go along with seaming also serve the purpose of decoration. These are visible on the right side of the garment to emphasize the design details. These seams can be done with the matching or contrasting colored threads according to the purpose for which these are required. One which we have is top stitched seam. And this is a seam that adds strength and is flat and also decorative. It is used to emphasize design details or keep seam and seam edges flat. It is a simple open seam with the under turnings top stitched. With right sides together, stitch a plain seam and press it open on the wrong side. If the fabric frays, neaten the turnings before top stitching. From the right side, top stitch close to the seam on either side. This double seam is referred as double top stitching. If the seam allowance is pressed to one side and top stitched closer to the seam through all layers, it is called single top stitching. It produces a cord-like effect in woolen fabrics. It is used with top stitching closer to the seam line on thin fabrics and in which the seams are exposed to higher strain, such as slips, children's clothes and sports garments. Coming to the piped or the corded seams, when a cord is enclosed in between the strip, it is termed as corded seam. The seam is very often used at the waistline and yoke line of dresses, and a bias strip of contrasting colors used as an extra piece in between the plain seam. On the right side, the bias piece is seen extended between the two pieces of material. It is customary to choose the cord according to the weight of the fabric. A fine cord for cotton and lightweight linen fabrics, and a heavier cord for thick fabrics. Take cord length according to seam length and cover it with a bias strip. Stitch close to the cord. And place the covered cord between the two layers of fabric with right sides of fabric together and tack the four seam allowances of the fabric together. Stitch as close as to the cord as possible using a presser foot meant for this purpose. To add decorative touch, use contrast colored material for bias. For very bulky fabrics, stitch the covered cord to one layer of fabric only, then keep the two layers of fabric right sides together and stitch. This stiffens the seam and gives added decorative touch in slip covers, for outlining yoke lines and at waistlines of children's dresses. Then another important seam is the lappet seam. This is a smooth flat seam which is stitched on the right side, and it is used for non-woven fabrics such as sewed fabrics and leather types. Other seams are not possible due to the structural feature of the garment like a yoke. It is especially useful for attaching plain material to a gathered section and joining the sections of interfacing and interlinings. It is also used for curved seams. For making this, turn the seam elements of the overlapping section to the wrong side. Clip the curves, trim points and reinforce the corners. Lap this over the underneath section, placing the fold along the seam line with right side up. Top stitch close to the fold through all layers from the right side. Stitch again 0.5 cm away if desired. And then another decorative seam is the slot seam. It is a variation of lappet seam. It's purely for decoration purpose, used as a fashion seam in skirts, blouses, suits, coats and children's clothes made of foam fabrics that give crisp edges. It resembles an inverted pleat used on center front back in skirts. To make a slot seam, turn under 0.5 cm on both cut edges. Place both folds onto a separate strips of the same fabric of the same length as that of the seam and cut on the same grain. Stitch one fold line on either side and neaten the inside edges. Channel seam is a variation of the slot seam, and for a channel seam, place both the folded pieces with edges touching each other on to a separate strip. Tack in position and machine stitch at an edge on either side. To make it decorative, the strip of fabric can be of contrast color and design. Then coming to the seam finishes. Some seams, such as plain seam, leave raw edges open. And after making seam, the seam edges need to be finished to prevent them from raveling during use, to provide strength to the seam and to improve the appearance of the inside of the garment. The purpose of the seam finishing is also to make the seam elements inconspicuous from the right side in transparent fabrics and to cover the very rough edges in stiff fabrics such as organdi. Fabrics such as velvet, jersey, wool, broadcloth, etc. do not require any finishing as they do not ravel at all. It is wise to choose the seam finish that suits the texture of the fabric and is made quickly without adding bulk to the fabric. Trimming is the process of cutting away both seam elements to the same width, but grading is necessary when several layers of fabrics are joined together. This is done by trimming the seam width to different widths. Later, they are pressed in a manner in which the widest seam width is on top, enclosing the other shorter seam widths. The factors considered for determining the seam finish, they are the type and weight of the fabric, the amount and kind of wear and tear the garment will undergo during the use, and whether or not seams will be conspicuous on the right side. Now, we will discuss the various types of seams finishes for plain seam and their suitability on different types of fabrics. Pinked or stitched and pinked finishes are there. This is the quickest method for finishing the raw edges and is least bulky. This method of finishing is suitable for firm fabrics that do not ravel at all, and after stitching plain seam, trim off about 1/8 inch of the seam elements using the pinking shears, or we can stitch the 0.5 centimeter from each seam edge and then trim close to the stitch line with the pinking shears and press open or press to one side. And another finish is the turned and stitched finish. This is an easy method of finishing the light and medium weight fabrics. Turn around 0.3 centimeter from the raw edges and stitch close to the fold. It is suitable for fabrics that are washed frequently and may ravel too much for pinking. This provides neat appearance for unlined jackets. Another one is the bond finish. This method is used for heavy, coarse fabrics that fray easily and are too thick to be turned and stitched, such as tweeds, and also for unlined coats and jackets. To make this, stitch bias or straight strip of a thinner fabric on each seam edge. Fold the binding around the edge of the fabricated stitch close to the edge. This is also referred to as seam binding. For finishing seams on thin fabrics, bias binding is attached, keeping both the edges together after pressing them to one side. Ready-made bias or satin seam bindings are easy to apply and they are available in the market. Zigzag stitching finish. The zigzag stitching finish is used for heavy fabrics that travel quickly and is suitable for others as well. These diagonal stitches encase the raw edges and prevent fraying. Zigzag near the seam's edge but not over the seam. Press over and trim off the edges closer to the row of zigzag stitches. Use a small zigzag stitch on a finer fabric and a larger stitch on a heavier fabric. It is an ideal seam finish for slightly elastic fabrics such as jersey and such other knitted fabrics. In coming to the overcast finish, this method can be used separately on each pressed open seam elements if the fabric is heavy, or both seam elements can be pressed together and oversewn as one is thinner fabric. Depending on the weight of the fabric, make slanting stitches of 0.5 centimeters apart and 0.3 centimeters in depth. Do not pull the thread too tightly. It produces a flat finish and prevents raveling, and it is especially suitable for arms and waistlines. And loop stitched finish, Like overcasting, this method can be used separately on each seam edges or both seam edges together and provides a decorative finish using the loop stitches. Then we have a herringbone stitched finish, and this is used together to neaten the raw edges and hold down the turning of heavy fabrics such as infants flannel clothing, where seams need to be flat and smooth. Use this stitch separately on pressed open seam edges and work over the raw edges in such a manner that it does not fray because raw edges are turned inside. And one important stitch that is used in many of these fabrics is overlock stitched finish. It is the quickest method for finishing the raw edges, especially in commercial places, as it is done with overlocking machine. It can be used separately on each pressed open seam elements on heavy fabrics or both seam elements together. It can be pressed and overlocked. As one in light to medium weight fabrics, it is used. It is mainly used for all straight seams. And we have few hints, you know, we can follow for stitching and finishing of the seams. When joining a plain edge to a gathered edge, stitch with the gathered side up and then press open the first seam before it is crossed with the second seam when you are crossing the seams together. And the bias edge should be on top when it is being stitched or attached to a straight edge. While joining two bias edges, stretch the seam slightly while being stitched because the bias edges always stretch while stitching. After stitching curved seams, clip the seam edges towards stitching in order to make it flat, and then seams may sometimes need to be trimmed or graded for reducing the bulk. While pressing, either a plain side joined to fuller side or yoke to a gathered section, keep the plain always on top. Side seams should be pressed to the back side and entire front seams to the right sides. Thus, we have seen number of seams, how we can make them and how actually finish these seams. As we said in the beginning that the seams and seam finishes are very important items of to actually grade or to judge the workmanship of the garments. Unless these seams are made properly, the garment will not look good. You know, if there are folds at the seam level, it does not look nice at all. So, learning how to actually make these seams and also how these seams can be made on the fabrics is very important, and also seeing the suitability of the seam for different edges is also important.